Hello students, welcome to my channel. In this video we will discuss about the thermodynamic of Schottky defect. Okay, in the previous videos I explained about the Schottky defect in detail. Okay, now what is Schottky defect? The Schottky defect is nothing but result defect arises whenever the number of cation missing is equal to the number of anion missing. Okay, the number of anion missing. Okay, then we call it as Schottky defect. Okay, if in the solid the number of cation missing is equal to the number of anion missing, then what do we call? We call it as a Schottky defect. Okay, in this video we will discuss about the thermodynamic. Okay, thermodynamic part of Schottky defect. Now, if you consider a solid NaCl, okay, if you consider a solid NaCl, then the Schottky equilibrium is given by the Schottky. Equilibrium is given by Na plus Cl minus plus VnaS plus VClS. Okay, it is in equilibrium with NaS plus ClS plus VnaS plus VCl minus. Okay, now we will understand what are these terms represent. Now imagine you have the solid NaCl. Okay, this is the NaCl, and within this solid we have what? We have Na, we have Cl minus. Okay, Na plus Cl minus, Na plus Cl minus. Okay, similarly you have Cl minus Na plus, like this. Okay, the solid or ions Na plus and Cl minus is not only present at the interior of the NaCl, right? It can be present at the surface of the solid also, correct? If you consider NaCl solid, the Na plus and Cl minus will be present at the surface of the solid as well as it will be present at the interior of the solid. Okay, like this. Now here I written Na plus and Cl minus, right? These Na plus and Cl minus represent, these are the ions at the interior of the solid. Okay, what is Na plus and Cl minus? Na plus and Cl minus are, these are the ions at the interior of the solid. Interior of solid, which is solid? NaCl solid. Okay, now I have written in this side NaS and ClS, means these are the ions, sodium ion and chloride ion at the surface. Okay, NaS and Cl minus means what? These are the ions at the surface of the solid. Okay, now what is VnaS and VCl minus? Now suppose if I remove the ions, say if I am removing the sodium ion from the surface, then the vacancy that is created at the surface for sodium ion is VnaS. Okay, what is VnaS? It is the vacancy for the sodium ion at the surface. Okay, similarly VCl minus means it is the vacancy that is created if Cl minus at the surface is removed. Okay, VnaS, VCl minus means it is the vacancy for the ions at the surface. Now VnA plus and VCl minus means what? If I remove the sodium ion and the chloride ion from the interior of the solid, then that vacancy created, no, that is called as VnA plus and VCl minus. Okay, this is at the interior, while these are the vacancies that are created at the surface of the solid. Okay, now this entire reaction is called as Schottky equilibrium. Okay, now the equilibrium constant can be given by, the equilibrium constant is given by capital K. Okay, equilibrium constant is a capital K, is nothing but as a concentration of product divided by concentration of a reactant. Okay, in this equation this is the product and this is the reactant. Just write it by putting a square bracket indicating that it is a concentration. Okay, concentration of NaS, concentration of ClS, concentration of VnA plus, concentration of VCl minus. Okay, what did I write? I just written this product. Okay, denominator is this, concentration of Na plus, concentration of Cl minus, VnaS. Okay, and then you have VClS. Okay, this is the equilibrium constant. Okay, equilibrium constant is a capital K. Now when VnaS is equal to NaS, and VCl S is equal to Cl. Yes, okay. That means if you have the solid and we imagine that these are the ions, this is Na, this is Cl, Na, this is Cl. Okay, now if I remove 2 Na from the surface, okay, if I remove 2 Na from the surface, then how many vacancies are created? The 2 vacancies are created at the surface, correct? If I remove 2 Na from the surface, then how many vacancies? VnAs is 2. Okay, if I remove 2 Cl minus, how many vacancies created? 2. That means the number of ions at the surface is equal to the vacancy that is created by removing that particular ion, correct? So this is the thing. Then what you need to do is you need to substitute over here, or you just cancel out the terms here. Here VnAs is here and NaS present here. Now these are equal, no? They can be cancelled out. Okay, similarly VClS here and ClS in the numerator, they get cancelled because these are equal. Now I write K, okay, just by removing those terms, VnA plus and VCl minus, denominator is Na plus Cl minus, okay, just by removing these terms I just written as such. Okay, now then we need to consider some terms here. Okay, put on the page. Now if you consider, now if you consider n, small n, okay, capital N, okay, if you consider capital N to be total number of sites that are occupied, which is a lattice site, okay, total number of lattice site that are occupied by Na plus and Cl minus, okay, and if small n represent the number of vacancy, the number of vacancy for any kind of ion, any kind of ion, any kind of ion means what? It may be Na plus or it may be Cl, okay, chloride ion. Okay, what is N? N is the total number of sites that are occupied and N is the total number of vacancy for any kind of ion, it may be a sodium ion or chloride ion. Then capital N minus N indicates what? Indicates that the total number of lattice sites that are still occupied by ion. Right, N means what? Total number of sites are occupied and N means vacancies. If you subtract N minus N, what you get? The total number of ions still remaining in the site. The total number of ions still remaining in their site. Okay? In their site. Now just imagine, I am just making it clear. Imagine there are 10 lattice sites. Okay, just imagine in a solid there are 10 lattice sites are there. Okay, that is what capital N is. Now N means vacancies, right? Just imagine I am removing 2 sodium ion and 2 chloride ion. That means number of vacancies what? 4. Then what is N minus 4 represent, or N minus N represent is 10 minus 4, right? That is 6. That means 6 ions are still remaining in their site. That is what I mean here. N minus N means what? Is the total number of ions still remaining in their site. Now what you do is you just substitute these terms in the equilibrium constant equation. K is equal to, look here, VNA plus and VCl minus is what? Is a vacancy. So which is the term? Which is the term I use here? N. Okay, that is N into N. Okay, why I am writing 2 times? Because here you have the vacancy for the sodium ion into the vacancy of chloride ion, right? That is why N into N. Here in the denominator you have Na plus Cl minus. That means these are the ions are still remaining in the lattice site. Okay, that means which term we have? We have N minus N. N minus N and N minus N. Okay, well, now N into N means what? It is nothing but N square, and N minus N into N minus N is capital N, N minus N whole square. Okay, just I written by multiplying this term. Now whenever this term, that means number of vacancy or number of defect is very very less than capital N. Okay, whenever this N is very less than number of sites that are occupied by ion, then N minus N, here you have N minus N, no? That can be write as capital N itself. Okay, since N is very less than N, no, you can neglect the small n and write it as capital N. Okay, I'll just write that only. N square, N minus N can be written as N square. Okay, so now by this equation, what is N square? N square is N square, capital N square and K. Okay, just cross multiply. Okay, N means what? Square root of N into K, N square into K, and you get N into square root of K. Correct? You get this equation, named as equation number 1. Okay, next what you need to consider is you need to consider some terms like free energy, changing free energy. From the thermodynamic, the free energy, changing free energy can be given by this particular equation, that is minus RT ln K. Correct? Delta G is a change in free energy is equal to minus RT ln K. What is K here? K is nothing but this K. Okay, what is that K? K is the equilibrium constant. Okay, now you need to write this equation as K equal to. Okay, if you write ln K by this equation, what happened? This minus RT comes to the denominator, minus RT like this, right? Then you need to write K like equal to. If ln go to other side, it become an exponential, right? Exponential of delta G by minus RT. Okay, now once again we have delta G equal to what? We have the delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, right? Delta H means change in the enthalpy, delta S is the change in the entropy. Now what I do is I just substitute delta G over here. Okay, in the previous equation I'll be substituting that delta G. K is equal to exponential. In place of delta G, I am writing delta H minus T delta S divided by you have RT. Now just open the bracket, exponential minus delta H by RT into exponential minus and minus become plus T delta S by RT. Okay, this is the thing. Now K is equal to exponential minus delta H by RT exponential. Okay, I hope you understood why I written exponential here, because if you have exponential AB, then you can write it as what? A plus B exponential A into exponential B, right? So same thing I written over here. Okay, then here T get cancels. You have delta S by R. Okay, here in this equation, this term is a constant. Okay, delta S by R, exponential delta S by R is a constant. So I write this equation like this. Constant into, what is constant? Instead of writing this term, I written constant. Okay, exponential minus delta H by RT. Okay, now what you do is you just take this equation number 2. Okay, now what you do? Substitute 2 in equation number 1. Okay, in the equation number 1, we have what? N is equal to N square root of K. Correct? In the place of K, just substitute the value. N is equal to capital N constant exponential minus delta H by RT to the power half. Okay, why it is half? Because square root is there, no? That is why half. Now just open the bracket, N constant power half exponential minus delta H by RT to the power half. Constant to the power, anything is a constant only, right? So I write constant, okay, because constant to the power anything is a constant only. So exponential minus delta H, I write 2 in the denominator like this. Okay, this can be written like this also. Half in the new power can be written like this. Okay, this is the final equation in the case of thermodynamic or Schottky defect. Okay, this is the derivation part. If you have any doubt in this derivation, please let me know in the comment section. Okay, and in the next video, what we do is we will be studying about the thermodynamic of Frenkel defect. Okay, if you like this video, please like it and share it also. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that it helps me to, you know, grow, help me to do more videos regarding my MSc solid state chemistry. Okay. Okay. This is all about this video. Thank you for watching. Okay.